Hi, I'm Bob DeToma, and I'm in Worcester, Massachusetts. This is the Higgins Armory, America's premier collection of arms and armor from around the world. Rick and I are going to tour the facility, and I hope you'll join us. Creator of Higgins Armory, John Woodman Higgins, was born in Worcester, Massachusetts on West Street, September 1st, 1874. His father was affiliated with Worcester Polytechnical Institute, and he was co-founder and president of the Norton Company. With the exception of 1 year in Atlanta, Georgia, Higgins was schooled entirely in Worcester, Massachusetts, and he was fascinated with metalworking and studied for hours metal workers and factory workers and how they worked with metal. John Higgins, like many of his contemporaries, was fascinated with tales of knights and knighthood, and this manifested itself in his lifelong devotion to the study of steel. While honeymooning in Europe, Mr. Higgins purchased his first suit of armor. It was a modern reproduction. Upon returning from Europe, he settled down with his family and built his home in Worcester, Massachusetts. And it featured many fascinating modern innovations. Coat dryers, ice machines, secret panels. And his cellar was painted steely silver to reflect his love of all things metal. In 1928, John Higgins purchased his first significant piece of armor for his collection. And as his collection grew, he conceptualized a museum in which to house his collection and show his devotion to steel. John Woodman Higgins, pictured here, conceptualized a museum that would serve as a temple to the art of metalworking. He envisioned a commercial museum. And when his dream was finally realized in 1931, the Higgins Steel Museum was housed along with the Worcester Press Steel offices in a new state-of-the-art glass and steel curtain wall building. After touring the museum, visitors were invited to watch the manufacture of modern steel products in Worcester's pressed steel factory, which Higgins called the biggest exhibit of them all. It's not just about arms and armor. It's about steel and metal and how man works with metal. Some of the items on display in this case. On the far left is a gondola prow. Following to the right is a beaded box made of metal from Japan. An articulated dragon, the tatsu. An articulated lobster. Above the lobster from Spain is a folding knife. And as we work our way to the right past the artwork, which is a bowl of fruit, we have a figurine, a lamp holder, an ancient pair of scissors, and on the far right, a stork. This is The Study of a Night Watchman, done by Norman Rockwell in 1962 at the Higgins Armory. And this eventually became the cover of the November 3rd issue of Saturday Evening Post. What was one of the deadliest things that a knight in chainmail had to face on the battlefield? How about a crossbow? Scholars believe that the invention of the crossbow gave rise to the use of plate armor by knights on the battlefield. This suit of armor was purchased by Mr. Higgins in France in 1926, and he was quite excited because this was the first piece in his collection large enough for him to wear. This is my good friend, Saint Florian, and he is the patron saint of firefighters. It is reputed that he saved a city from burning with one bucket of water. This is an exclusive shot of what it looks like from the inside of a piece of helmet armor. Your field of vision is limited by this slit. You're surrounded by enemies to your left and to your right. You have to move your head constantly to see your enemies as they approach. I'm in the guest gallery, and this is a Roman soldier's helmet. The guest gallery is where young visitors can get a hands-on experience with these pieces and see what it's like to be a knight. Professor Bell's tips on observing the unobservable. What you see and what you think you see are not always the same. Use all of your senses. Take careful note of size, shape, color, disposition, and location. And remember, watch where you put your feet. I'm in the office of the curator of curiosities. The office is manned by Mr. Rufus Excalibur Bell. My young penguin friend and I were marveling over the items in this hall. So as I walk through the Hall of Curiosities, I see a winged flying machine, the embryo of a demon, the giant Beakosaurus, but a demon-reducing machine. You place the demon in the top, and he gets reduced at the bottom, about the size of a chicken. The head of the horned dragon, and what appears to be the hand of a winged man. The skeleton of a miniature centaur, the heart of a demon, the head of Anubis, the beak of a giant squid. We're inside the Oddities Warehouse. The first item of curiosity is Captain Nemo's favorite diving suit. Does the abominable snowman exist? No, but the corpse of the Yeti does. The curator found this dragon's wing off the coast of New Zealand and brought it to Worcester, Massachusetts.